Good afternoon, all of you. Hope everybody is safe in your home. Take care. So, in the last video, you have watched a hardware demonstration on how a physical quantity is measured using data acquisition system.
In this video, we will learn about the definition and classification of transducer. Before starting this session, let us recap the previous session quickly. So we defined the purpose of data acquisition system using NI LabVIEW software in the last video. A PowerPoint presentation describing the functional elements of data acquisition system is also shared. And the contents of PowerPoint presentation includes a definition and purpose of data acquisition system. So this is how we define the data acquisition system. It is a collection of hardware and software to measure and store the physical parameters of the real world. It consists of sensors, signal conditioning units, data acquisition hardware, a computer with programmable software and display and storage devices. So the schematic shows a National Instruments supplied hardware, wherein they have a DAC device which includes signal conditioning. Normally, this signal conditioning is a separate functional element in data acquisition system, but this National Instruments, they have embedded this signal conditioning in DAC device itself. So this schematic shows the functional elements of data acquisition system. So physical system whose physical parameter is to be measured, and the physical parameters may be analog or digital, so many forms. And this transducer converts this physical parameter into electrical output. The electrical output of the transducer may contain some noises, or the signal may be weak. So we need amplifiers or filters which forms a signal conditioning element. So signal conditioning elements are those which is used to amplify the transducer output or to filter out the noise. And we have analog to digital converter, which converts this electrical output into digital output to be fed to the computer, so that computer process the data and make it available for the display and storage devices. Few applications include industries, research labs, automotive systems, power distribution and maintenance, and so on. So this schematic shows a data acquisition system for a multivariable system, wherein we are interested in monitoring more than one physical parameter. So we need a multiplexer to select one of the channel out of the transducer outputs, and we have the display and storage devices. So to sum up, the functional elements include a sensor or transducer, a signal conditioner, data acquisition hardware, computer storage and display devices. So to list a few of the sensor or transducer, there are a thermistor, thermocouple, strain gauge, and so on. Bridge circuit, differential amplifier, instrumentation amplifier, filter, voltage to current converter or current to voltage converter forms a signal conditioner. The analog to digital converter, multiplexer, processor and driver software forms data acquisition hardware. So understanding, controller is essential part of data acquisition system. No, controller need not be essential part of the data acquisition system. So the answer is false. Identify the signal conditioning device. Thermometer is a sensor. Magnetic tape is a recorder. Amplifier is the signal conditioning device. Whereas analog to digital converter, it is the part of DAC hardware. Computer is used as data dash device. So computer is used for data logging. Computer is used for data processing. Sometimes it is also used for data displaying, but it is not used for data printing. So the answer is logging, processing and displaying. So this is the assignment we posted a week before for this data acquisition system. Mr. John works for Schlumberger Oil Industry as an instrumentation engineer. He decides to install 4 temperature transducers in a boiler to monitor the temperature with digital displays and acquire the data in a computer. To help Mr. John bring out the schematic of functional devices involved in this temperature monitoring system for boiler. Many of you have responded positively to this assignment. My appreciations to all of you. And I have also given feedback for all your individual submissions. Let us see some of the student submissions to understand. So this is an assignment submitted by a student, schematic of data acquisition system. So he has used a temperature sensor separately and then a transducer. So he means there is a sensing element and then there is a conversion element. So he has used two different functional elements for measurement itself. So sensor and then transducer, signal conditioner and then multiplexer to select these outputs, and then A to D, and this makes sense. This is another assignment submitted by a student where she has used a thermocouple as a transducer. So directly she has used a temperature measuring device, thermocouple. She called this as active transducer. We will see what is the meaning for this active. Maybe she is ahead of learning. Yes. And the output of thermocouple is millivolt in terms of millivolt. So we need an instrumentation amplifier to boost up this thermocouple output. And then multiplexer, analog to digital converter, computer, and then display device. And a few description also. So this makes a lot of sense. So there is no single schematic for this data acquisition system and for the assignment post. So the schematic depends upon the transducer that is used and signal conditioner that is used. So there is no separate single answer. I hope you understand this. So this completes the previous session topics, and what we have today is this we have completed. Today we'll define transducer, classify transducer on different terms. So how transducers are classified? Classified based on power source, conversion, working principle, and then transduction principle. So what is a transducer? A transducer is a device that converts any physical quantity into electrical quantity. So we all know that transducer converts a physical parameter into electrical parameter. Transducer includes a sensing element and then a transduction element. So sensing element, it actually converts one form of physical quantity into another form of physical quantity. Transduction element converts this physical quantity into electrical output. We'll see how this happens. So we have strain gauge. So strain gauge is a sensing element. It actually detects force or load applied to it and provides a resistance. And this is a Wheatstone bridge circuit wherein this resistance is converted into electrical output. So sensing element, the input is force or load, and we get resistance. So sensing element is one which converts one physical parameter into another physical parameter. Here the force or load is converted into resistance, sensing element, strain gauge. Transduction element is one thing where this resistance, you apply resistance, this is converted into electrical output. So transduction element is one thing which converts this physical parameter into electrical output. So transducer as a sensing element and then transduction element. So strain gauge is a sensing element, one physical form to another physical form, and then electrical output, transduction. Okay. So classify the transducer. So based on power source, there is a classification. So passive transducer, that means if a transducer needs external power supply for its operation, this is a transducer. Linear variable differential transformer is a transducer. So it needs a power source for its operation. Then we call this transducer as passive transducer. And if a transducer does not need any power source for its operation, we call that as active transducer. So thermocouple, we know thermocouple works on the principle of Seebeck effect, where thermoelectric EMF is generated when two bimetals are connected together. So the output is EMF. So there is no external supply needed to generate this thermo EMF in thermocouple. And then another classification is based on conversion. So if a transducer converts non-electric quantity into electric quantity, we call it as a transducer. But if a transducer converts electric quantity into non-electric quantity, we call that as inverse transducer. So inverse transducer converts electric quantity into non-electric quantity. For example, piezoelectric transducer. So if you apply EMF, it provides force. In principle, the transducers are classified as primary transducer and secondary transducer. Primary transducer is nothing but the sensing part, which we discussed earlier. And transduction part, we call it as secondary transducer. So sensing part, primary transducer. Transduction part, secondary transducer. So three classifications so far based on power source, conversion, working principle, and then based on transduction principle. So the phenomena involved in transduction may be resistive phenomena, inductive phenomena, or capacitive phenomena. So if a transducer gives electric output, based on resistive phenomena, we call it as resistive transducer. If a transducer gives electrical output based on inductive phenomena, we call it as inductive transducer. If a transducer gives electric output based on capacitive phenomena, we call it as capacitive transducer. So here we have this inductive transducer, and this is resistive transducer, and this is the schematic explains the working of capacitive transducer. We'll see one by one. And in today's session, we will see resistive transducer. So what is this resistive transducer? So resistance between the output terminals of the transducer varies according to the physical quantity being measured. So the resistive transducer is one thing whose resistance varies. For example, strain gauge. So here the potentiometer is also a resistive type transducer. So there are different types of resistive transducers. Potentiometer is one thing where you get electric output based on the resistance variation. Strain gauge based transducer is a resistive transducer. Thermistor based transducer is also a resistive transducer. Thermistor stands for thermal resistor, so is used to measure temperature. Output is resistance. There is another device used to measure temperature. Resistance temperature detector is also a resistive transducer. So we call it as RTD. RTD is a resistive transducer. So today we'll see how this RTD functions as a resistive transducer. This is a schematic or image of a RTD. It has three leads here, And this is well-known phenomena, resistance. Equals resistivity of the material, length and area of the material used. Construction, how RTD is constructed. So this is nothing but the cut section of this sensing element in RTD. So this is the sensing element in RTD, and RTD has three leads. You can see here it has three leads here. Normally, platinum is widely used as the resistive element in RTD. So this sensing element is normally platinum. We call this as platinum 100, PT100. PT100 means it provides 100 ohms resistance at 0 degree Celsius. So RTD is used to measure temperature. So if the temperature is 0 degree Celsius, the output of RTD will be 100 ohms. So it provides 100 ohms resistance at 0 degree Celsius. And how this resistance is converted into electrical output, this is how it's very similar to the strain gauge circuit we discussed in the last video. And this, so three leads are here for RTD. So likewise here also three leads. And see, this is where the current flows in the RTD. So current enters here like this and it flows. So here also in this bridge circuit, current flows through the RTD through this this R1, and then it comes out. And this is the output resistance of the RTD. It is connected in the bridge circuit. And this output is the final electrical output. So this is how RTD provides resistance, is converted into electrical output. So it measures temperature. So output is resistance and is converted into electrical output. And furthermore, the resistance of platinum increases with increase in temperature. So RTD is used to measure temperature. So if we increase the heat supply to the RTD, the resistance also increases. So resistance of the platinum increases with increase in temperature. This is called positive temperature coefficient of resistance. So positive temperature coefficient of resistance means the resistance increases with increase in temperature. This happens in RTD with platinum. And this equation is the equation to describe how the resistance of RTD is calculated theoretically. So this RT stands for resistance of RTD. So R0 is the resistance in ohms at 0 degree Celsius. So for a platinum PT100, this R0 at 0 degree Celsius will be, yes, 100 ohms. So R0 will be 100 ohms because it is PT100. So R0 is 100 ohms at 0 degree Celsius. And then RT is the resistance that is to be measured. And alpha is the temperature coefficient of resistance for the material. It is a constant. And T is the temperature that is to be measured. So T is the temperature that is to be measured, and RT is the final resistance of the RTD. This RTD can be used to measure temperature ranging from minus 250 degree Celsius to 900 degree Celsius. So this explains about how RTD works. So that's all. A quick summary of the today's session. So we have discussed the functions of transducer, classifications of transducer based on power source, active transducer and passive transducer, based on conversion principle, electric to non-electric, non-electric to electric, based on the working principle, primary transducer, secondary transducer, based on the transduction principle, resistive, inductive and capacitive. And we discussed the resistive transducer with an example of RTD as a resistive transducer. Thank you all for your patient watching and listening. Don't forget to give your comments in the comment section of this video. Okay, fine. Thank you. And I will meet once again in the next video. Until then, bye from Dr. Balaji Madhavan.